The women's marathon this morning, and of course now we are covering women's basketball. Those are considered really two of the glamour events of these Olympic Games. But in all, there are 221 events in this year's Olympics, and we'd like to take some time today to show you some of the different types of competition you might not have seen yet. First, there's yachting, which is being held in Long Beach, California. Here's Mark Spitz.
After 4 days of racing, the United States is in the running for gold medals in all seven classes. With three races remaining, an incredible story is unfolding for the U.S. In the 470 class, after a breakdown in the first race, Steve Benjamin still holds on to second overall, behind Luis Doresti of Spain. In the new sport of wind gliding at the Olympic Games, Scott Steele of the U.S. is pulling the biggest upset in yachting thus far. Not expected to be in the top 10, he is now first overall after four races. The favored Stefan Vandenberg of Holland holds on to second place. The Canadians are first overall in the Flying Dutchman class with Terry McLaughlin at the helm. Jonathan McKee of the United States was the first American to ever win a world championship in this event and now has a chance to win a gold medal in this class. In the sailing class, Anastasios Boudaris of Greece is second overall at the end of four races, but heavily favored Robbie Haynes of the United States barely holds on to first overall. Surrounded by controversy, John Bertrand of the United States, after 2 months of court hearings and five different decisions, got his chance to compete in the Olympic Games 3 days before competition began. Plagued by a disqualification in the first race, he has come back to hold on to second overall behind Russell Coutts of New Zealand. In the star class, after winning the first race, Bill Buchan of the United States has been plagued with problems but still holds on to second place overall behind Kent Carlson of Sweden. The Tornado, unlike other boats, is a catamaran capable of speeds of 30 miles per hour. After four races, Randy Smythe of the U.S. is in second overall, behind leader Rex Sellers of New Zealand. The final three races begin on Monday, and America has never looked better with chances of gold in every event.
Last night, during the opening competition of judo, the most honored guest was Dr. Matsumai, president of the International Judo Federation. What he and 4,000 other spectators saw was a test in courage and perseverance. Ed Liddy was in the bronze medal match with Guy Devon of France. In this weight category, the United States was not predicted to win a medal. Son of a police judo instructor, 25-year-old Ed Liddy, had only the slightest of odds in his favor as he entered the competition last night. Early in the match, the Frenchman scored the first of his two kokas. There it is. Now, a koka is the smallest score in judo. It does not accumulate during a match, but it can win a match if it is the only kind of point scored. Later on, with only 2:20 left in the five-minute match, Ed Liddy could see his chances for a medal begin to fade away. Both men accidentally butted heads. Liddy was stunned, and he fell to his back. As you can see in the replay, the butt was ever so slight, but enough to knock Liddy to the mat. Everything seemingly was working against him. Then, with less than 1 minute on the clock, and the action intense, Liddy scored what is called a yuko. Here it comes. There it is. A yuko now is worth more than a koka and is enough to win a match. Ed Liddy could see a glimmer of hope left on the horizon, and the crowd could certainly appreciate Ed's timing in this match. The clock began its slow countdown. Both Ed and the crowd could sense victory. Victory in a sport that has long been dominated by the Asians. And there it was. Until last night, Americans had only won two previous medals in the Olympic sport of judo. Ed Liddy's bronze became an exciting third. And his enthusiasm and skill, hopefully, will spur the American team to more success in a sport that is growing ever more popular in this country. Ed Liddy winning the bronze in the extra lightweight division of the judo competition. Baseball is making its first appearance in the Olympics, and although it's only a demonstration sport, they are playing with the same enthusiasm as any other sport here. The crowd numbered in excess of 50,000 at Dodger Stadium for the U.S. team's game with the Dominican Republic, and yesterday the star for the U.S. team was 20-year-old Will Clark of New Orleans. Clark already had singled in the third inning, then with one on in the fifth inning, he smashed this home run into the right field seats. What a day this youngster had. The United States, well represented in the grandstand, scored four runs in that inning and increased their lead to 6-0. Clark continued his hitting heroics with the double in the sixth inning. Clark was hitting a hefty .444 prior to yesterday's game, and he didn't do anything to hurt it. Clark was greeted by a thunderous ovation from the crowd for his next at bat. A little hot dogging for us. Will answered the cheers with his second two-run home run. It was indeed a great day. Clark winding up the day with four hits and five at-bats with three runs scored. What a thrill for this youngster from New Orleans. And the customary chants were there. The team played well in the field on defense to wrap up a 12-0 victory.